Laser, I want to pick up on something he just mentioned, Iran. We have seen from Iran today that this vote will trigger political chaos. That's what they claim. And certainly if we're to look at how Iraq and Turkey have reacted, they're preparing for something, maybe even a military option. Do you agree that political chaos is on the way after this vote?
It's an option. I think what's really important right now is the time where we expect that Kurdistan's neighbors will make all sorts of pronouncements, and you'll hear things like we're hearing today. That's expected. The question moving forward is, what will Turkey do? That's Kurdistan's main economic partner. And what will the United States do? Is the United States really willing to risk breaking its anti-ISIS coalition over this vote? And based on the State Department's statement today, it doesn't seem that they will. They said that they are not going to change their relationship with Kurdistan based on this vote, even though the United States is officially against it.
At the same time, the State Department put out a pretty strong statement after the vote, saying they strongly condemn, that they are deeply disappointed that this vote went through. If the Kurds were hoping for support from the U.S. after their support for the U.S. in the fight against ISIS, they didn't get it. So what will that do going forward to all of these countries who are fighting side by side?
That is, I think, a very important question. It's hard to believe that these countries like Iraq will actually want to endanger its anti-ISIS coalition because of this, right? So we know that they were going to be opposed to it. We knew the United States and Europe would be opposed to it. Is there going to be an invasion of Kurdistan? Very hard to believe. The most drastic thing that could be done now is Turkey could close the borders. Iran is closing some airspace, but how long will they do that for? It's unclear, and it's unlikely, again, that anyone's going to actually send troops into Iraqi Kurdistan, least of all the Iraqi state.
Laser, let me try to get and elicit an opinion from you.
Sure.
I mean, there are those who would say that the Kurds, after decades of centuries of suffering at the hands of some of their neighbors, deserve their own state. And they have been loyal allies, certainly of the United States, both in the struggle from Islamic State and in some other instances and battles before it. Should the U.S. change its policy based on that historical record and give more support to the idea of Kurdish independence?
I certainly believe so, and it's somewhat hard for a state to take a moral position against Kurdish independence. Kurdistan has done everything right, everything that the international community would ask of it, in terms of opposing terrorism, opposing radical elements, and being reasonably pro-Western. So how can we say no to them?
So why do you think this happened now? Because as Khalev mentioned, this has been a dream of the Kurds in this part of the world for decades, if not more. Is it the hope, perhaps, maybe a naive hope, that there would be support from the United States or something else?
I think there's two reasons. One, the Kurds got sick of trying to wait for the Iraqi state to guarantee them security, stability, and prosperity. They voluntarily went into the federal Iraqi state, and they understand that they're not going to get their rights protected in an Iranian-dominated, Shiite-dominated Iraqi state. That's one. Let's also not forget that the president of the Kurdistan region, Masoud Barzani, is a de facto president. He is 2 years beyond any sort of potentially legal mandate, and he is trying to find ways to stay in power and to give himself legitimacy. And this, I think, is a very successful way based on the 85% result. The positive result, if that is indeed the result, he has succeeded in gathering new support for himself staying in office.
Laser, that's an oil-rich region there in Iraqi Kurdistan. What role does that possibly play in what's playing out?
That's a very crucial role, especially in the Kurdistan-Turkey relationship, because Kurdistan is exporting 600,000 barrels a day through Turkey. That's important for Turkey's vision of itself and its future as an oil power in the region. So that is a reason to believe that Turkey will not entirely close the border for very long. If Kurdistan is expecting to have a viable economy just based on oil, it's sadly mistaken. It really needs to diversify and build a modern economy.
Laser Berman, thanks very much for being here. We'll follow the result of that referendum when they become final, and certainly in the days, months, and maybe years to come. We're going to go out for a quick break. When we're back, much more on this, from that Kurdish referendum to the attack this morning just outside Jerusalem, and President Donald Trump said to give a joint press statement with his Spanish counterpart. All that's coming up live when we're back.
We're seeing some live pictures there from the Rose Garden at the White House, and we'll bring you that press conference as soon as it starts. Stay with us. We'll be right back.